I have a cold, and I was trying to go to sleep, but I kept on picturing a video. A question that I've been answering a couple times is, one, people are asking about smoothing surfaces on their prints, and then two, they're asking about making it easier for removing support materials. So this guy is a good example. It is a knob that I designed for a gas stove, and so it needs a lot of support because that whole big flat area would not print well. And one frustrating thing is removing said supports. And one thing that people are told often is change your support to 0.2. But if you go over here, there's no generating supports. There's nowhere to change that setting. So then over here, these three little dots, you have a couple different visibility settings. You can go and change custom visibility. However, what I prefer to do is I usually leave it on show all visibility. And by usually, I mean I just leave it on show all visibility. For this video, I had to change it back. And so what I would suggest is going through these settings, figuring out what you use most often, because it's a lot of settings there and a lot of really confusing things. But as you print, you'll be able to figure out little bit by little bit exactly what you need. And so over here, support Z distance is the one that by default is 0.1. However, I change that to 0.2, and then it automatically changes these other settings based on that. And so now that distance is a little bit longer, and 0.2 is generally what I found to be a good distance for supports with the Ender. And these should come off pretty easy. I'm not really worried about taking that off. It'll just be with the little snips and some pliers. And I mean, no one really sees the bottom. That's the great thing about a lot of the prints is that the ones that need support, oftentimes the area that they need, and designing, you want to make this a goal, the areas that need support aren't really something that's seen. But then, you know, they'll see the top. The second thing, if you followed the PDF, which I did at first, I followed the PDF that I got with the printer. If you followed that, even if you downloaded the new version of Cura, you didn't get, the latest and greatest in terms of the printer settings. So under Printer and Add Printer, I recorded this video already, and it didn't work, there are other printers. And they have the Ender now. They have the Ender now over here. And what's great is that it has more G-code. So wait for it to set up. Still waiting for it to set up. There we go. Okay. So then go back on the printer and manage printers and machine settings. Now, there's I'm not exactly sure who made this G-code, but it came with this version of Cura that I have. I always have to add G29 because I have BL Touch. Let's see. Mesh. So BL Touch mesh leveling. But what this does is it draws a line on the far left side, and that is really good for priming the printer. You want to have your bed leveled if you're doing this, though. If it's only leveled in the center, then that might be awkward. And then also various NG code. I like this because it moves the bed to the front and disables the steppers. Rather than with the other, the CR10G code, it moved the bed all the way to the back. But so, that's something really good. You want to go ahead and set it up. And look at that. You have the Ender logo right there, which I think it looks pretty good. And Ender Dragon, Ender's Game Dragon, they need to send Orson Scott Card some revenue. The last thing is over here, I have some profiles. These These profiles are Fat Dragon Games. Forgive me, I believe that's a name. Fat Dragon Games profiles. I'll provide a link in the description. These are my favorite profiles to use. The minis. I don't print minis. I don't print terrain. However, I'll use the minis one as a sort of smaller detailed items that I want to be really, really detailed. Terrain slow is something where it's like a bigger item, but I want it to be printed nicer. And then terrain fast is big item, printed as quickly as I can, but still really good settings. Now, one thing that I do change in all of the settings is I'll change the layer height to the 0.12 or either 0.24, which is a multiple of that. But that should do it for this. And if you guys have any questions, ask it down in the comments below. But there have been some changes to Cura, and then there are also things that have been sort of a little bit hidden in the settings that this hopefully will help some people out.